Hey, God bless you. Welcome back to ecpgencat.com. This is Sarai Rosado, and guess what? This is day 7. This is 1 week into the 21-day fast, and I want to congratulate you guys for making it this far. We've had our ups, we've had our downs, we've had our moments where our stomachs are making all types of noises. But I want to congratulate you because you have been a conqueror so far, and I encourage you guys to continue forward because the best is yet to come. Today is January 12, 2013. It's Saturday morning, and I'm very excited with today's word. Today I want to put the topic, enter the secret place. Now, I was meditating in the Lord, and I was asking him what it is that he wants to speak to me about in this day 7, and I couldn't help but think back at the Genesis, the creation. 7 is the perfect number. It's God's perfect number. So I wanted to go back to the beginning to see who is God or who he presented himself to be in Genesis. And I started looking at the creation. And day 7 is the day that God actually rests. And the Bible says that he rests. So the message that God wants to give you today is simply rest in him. Stop worrying about what you need to do. Stop stressing about what hasn't gotten done, but simply just rest in his presence. I want you to look up Psalm 139 verse 15, and it states, "My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in the secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth." This verse gets me so excited because it lets us in a secret, and that secret is that every one of us has a secret place, a place where it's only you and God knows about it. This is the place where David is saying that he was woven together, he was knitted, he was made. So if we all have this place, that means that we have access to it. We can go to it again. And the Lord wants to tell you that every time you enter into this secret place, you will be made. You would be woven together. A lot of times, you know, in this walk, you know, we have our ups and we have our downs. And it is important that in our downs, we're able to go into this place. And you may be asking, what is this place? I've never heard about this secret place. And I simply want to tell you, the secret place is a place where you can be yourself, where you take off the mask, where no one could understand if you were to just simply explain it to them. But God knows that place where you don't even have to speak, where you just simply close your eyes and you meditate in the Lord, and the spirit inside of you cries out to God, and it connects with God in a way where God starts taking away things and starts molding things and molding you into the person that he has already predestined for you to be. Now, this is the place where you will feel rested, where you would just rely on the Lord and rest in him, and he will form you once again. And every time you leave this place, it's a new you. It's a new person. You will be feeling rejuvenized. And I also want to read verse 16 of that same chapter. And David says, "Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be." I just want to tell you that there's a lot of things that sometimes God tells us, and sometimes we can't understand all those things. Sometimes there's a promise over our lives, and what we see with our eyes is contrary to what God has spoken. But I want to tell you this secret that the Spirit revealed to me through this verse, and it says that before that God looked at us when we were unformed, and all our days were already written in his book, and then he formed our bodies. Meaning that if God told you something, if God said that you're going to be a pastor, a preacher, a singer, an evangelist, a prophet, whatever it is that God said and God has spoken to you, and you know and you feel it in your heart, it will come to pass because the Lord already wrote it down and then He gave it to you. That is why He tells us that you are more than a conqueror, because it had already been established. And I want to encourage you guys that to enter into this secret place, this place where you're going to be rested and you're going to rely on the Lord to mold you into the person He wants you to be. It's not easy, but it's the best thing that will ever happen to you. Be real with the Lord. Tell God, God, I'm struggling with lying. I'm struggling with fornication. I'm struggling with forgiveness. I'm struggling with gossiping. I want to stop. I want to change, but I somehow can't. It's my weakness. And I want you to present it to God and let God start taking away things from your life and start adding things. Now, this is a secret place, so remember, it's a place where you have to go in it alone. It's a dark place, but remember what David says in that same chapter. If you read the whole chapter, says that it doesn't matter how dark it is, nothing, everything becomes light when God is in that place. So even if it's cold, if it's dark and you're alone, remember that God is with you and He has a plan with you and He wants to mold you. So every time you go into this place of origin, it's a place where God will start molding you and forming you and knitting you once again into the person He predestined you to be. I ask that you may leave a comment. I hope that you were blessed by this word, and I ask you to continue meditating in this chapter as you read it. God bless you, and please leave a comment. Let me know how you're doing. Have a great rest, a great Saturday. Enjoy the rest of this weekend, and I will see you soon. God bless.